We are hot off the heels of an epic NXT Rebellion. And no, it can't be. Mr. McMahon here in NXT? No way! Mr. McMahon showing his face for the first ever time here on NXT. Business is certainly about to pick up. Look at the way he's taking his time to the ring, soaking it all up. The crowd are on their feet. They can't believe what they are seeing. The chairman of the WWE making his way to the ring here in NXT for the first time ever. Incredible. And it looks as though we're going to hear from Mr. McMahon. I wonder what he's going to say. I wonder what he's got in store for us. Well, welcome everyone to a new era here in NXT. Ms. McMahon, the chairman of the WWE board, announced that NXT is a brand in itself. There is going to be new superstars, there's going to be a new championship, and last but not least, general manager William Regal has been relieved of his duties, and there is to be a new general manager announced soon. Who that will be, we're not sure at the moment, but I can't wait until that announcement is made. But first, to usher in this new era on NXT, Matt Sydal, formerly known as Evan Bourne, making his return here in the WWE on NXT. Who will he be going head-to-head against? New superstars, we can expect new superstars. I cannot wait to see what else Mr. McMahon, who has taken control of NXT at the moment, what else he has in store for us. And who is this? It's Johnny Gargano. Johnny Gargano here in NXT. Him and Matt Sydal going head to head against each other. We're certainly in for a classic here this evening. Both cruiserweights, both not afraid of that high flying, high octane sort of style of wrestling. We're going to see that here to kick off this evening's NXT. We are certainly heading in to a new era. Competition is certainly going to be stiff for the likes of Sami Zayn, our current NXT champion, as Mr. McMahon said. Sami Zayn retained his NXT championship. It was so impressive at Rebellion against Kevin Owens in that epic tables, ladders, and chairs match. And also the Ascension, our current NXT Tag Team Champions. Are we expecting new tag teams here on NXT as well? If we are, we are certainly in for a fantastic new era here in NXT. But we kick things off with Matt Sydal going head-to-head against Johnny Gargano. Well, this crowd looks ready. I'm certainly ready. Sure, you folks at home watching already, and more importantly, Matt Sydal and Johnny Gargano going head to head as we kick off the first match in this new era. Both superstars with that collar and elbow tie-up. Sydal with a bit more power behind it, pushing Gargano against the ropes. The referee having to come in and break this hold at Gargano with a slap across the face of Matt Sydal. And here we go again. Both guys tying up. Sydal just getting the upper hand here in strength over Johnny Gargano, and the referee coming in to break it up, but no slap this time. And there we go, there's those ruthless kicks from Matt Sydal. You can see on the back of his trunks there, reborn. Is this a new era for Matt Sydal here in the WWE, as Johnny Gargano has his holds reversed by Sydal, but Gargano again back into the driver's seat. And Matt Sydal says, whatever you can do, I can do better. Turns it back around into his favour. Big forearm across the back. And Gargano takes Sydal down to the canvas. This is not a good position to be in for Sydal, but somehow wriggles his way out. And what a kick to the midsection of Gargano. So this whole new era, which Miss McMahon announced at the start of this show, comes into full effect for the next episode. The crowd certainly enjoyed hearing that announcement. As this match continues on, Gargano looking precarious against the ropes. Gargano down to the ground. And look at this from Sydal. Oh, fantastic maneuver with that hurricanrana. And just look at the confidence of Matt Sydal. Got to consider Matt Sydal as a favourite here, as he has taken the upper hand. Gargano not in a good position at the moment, but finds a way out with that kick to the side of the head of Matt Sydal. Up in the corner, he wants to get out of the corner, and he does with a drop kick to Matt Sydal, taking him down to the canvas. Gargano, ooh, just locking in that arm, and he's just wrenching back, working on that spine, stretching it out. Will Sydal tap? No, Gargano breaks the hold. And look at Sydal with that elbow, but Gargano with another reversal on Sydal. Going for the scoop slam, Sydal slithers his way out of that hold, and Gargano sent to the ring apron, not a good place to be. But Gargano with that forearm smash, springboard drop kick from Gargano. Fantastic, he goes back outside, heading to the top. Sydal not in a good place, realizes that, starts to get to his feet, and Gargano decides not to take the risk of jumping from the top, whatever he had in mind. Sydal with a snap suplex to Johnny Gargano. He got some of the rope as well there. They're not very forgiving, those ropes. Gargano looking groggy at the moment. He's not in a good position. And now Matt Sydal into a hurricanrana for Johnny Gargano. Is it only a matter of time before we see that amazing shooting star press from Matt Sydal? Gargano still willing to fight on though. Nice German suplex to Matt Sydal. Gargano brings him back to his feet now. And what's this? Going for the powerbomb, but Sydal reverses it into a DDT. He got all of that, just spikes Gargano on his head, goes for the cover, has the leg hooked. Two! And Gargano kicks out at two there, keeping himself in this match. And there's one of those kicks to the back of the spinal area of Gargano. He's still on his feet, cinches in that headlock. And Sydal, can Sydal get himself out of this, which he's done a couple of times already in this match. And Sydal, yes, almost back to his feet here as the crowd watches on. And oh, what a kick to the side of the head to Sydal. And that could very well be it for Matt Sydal, as Johnny Gargano goes for the cover, has the leg hooked. We're at two, and Sydal kicks out at two. So very close. Gargano thinks he got a three there, complaining to the referee. Gargano lining Sydal up for something here, looking to put this one away. Skull crushing finale, planting Sydal into the mat. Goes for the cover, has the leg hooked again. Two, and Sydal! Sydal kicks out at 2.9, I should say. Now Sydal back to his feet somehow. Sydal, oh! What a clothesline up into the corner. Goes down to his knees, looking very tired at the moment, Sydal. This match certainly took it out of him as he's heading to the top. It's not looking good for Gargano at the moment. Shooting star press! Surely, is that it? Sydal has the leg hook. Two, three. And Matt Sydal has won the first match in this new era here on NXT. What a matchup between these two. This reversal from Sydal, perfectly done into the DDT. Took a lot of wind out of Gargano's sails, and that may have cost him the match, really. That was the beginning of the end. And as we've just seen, that perfect shooting star press from Matt Sydal. God, I've missed that move. Got the cover, had the leg hooked. The referee with a count of three. Fantastic performance, very impressive display from Matt Sydal, kicking off this new era in NXT. The future certainly does look bright. Well, what an amazing night NXT Rebellion was. The main event saw Sami Zayn defending his NXT Championship against Kevin Owens in a tables, ladders and chairs match. It was absolute bedlam. It was manic. Tables getting destroyed, ladders being used as weapons. The steel chairs also played a huge part in this match, and not in a nice way. And as we've just heard from Kevin Owens himself, if he wants another shot at Sami Zayn's NXT Championship, he's going to have to go through Samoa Joe here later this evening in the main event. Well, welcome back everyone to this week's NXT. The NXT Tag Team Champions, The Ascension, who haven't defended their titles now for some time. I mean, they haven't even competed in the NXT ring for some time. So they concede tonight as a way to blow away those cobwebs, to get rid of some ring rust, and to once again show us all why they have that NXT Tag Team Championship gold around their waist. Such a dominant side. We saw a couple of weeks ago they dismantled, they decimated the NXT champion Sami Zayn in that 2-on-1 handicap match. And these two, we've just never seen anything like this before. They know each other inside and out. They know each other's qualities to get the job done. And I would expect to see exactly the same here this evening. Let's find out then who could be heading into the wastelands. Crowd certainly ready. Connor and Victor of the Ascension ready. And it can't be. Oh my word. Alex Shelley and Chris Sabin of the Motor City Machine Guns. They are here in NXT. Well, we've already kicked off this evening with the return of Matt Sydal, formerly known as Evan Bourne. We've had Johnny Gargano, two new superstars here on the NXT roster. And now, Alex Shelley and Chris Sabin are set to go head-to-head against the NXT Tag Team Champions, The Ascension, and Victor and Connor. What an incredible way to kick off this new era in NXT. As Miss McMahon said himself, to open up this evening, NXT is a brand in itself. And what a match I'm sure we are in for here this evening between these two amazing tag teams. I believe the Ascension, they've never had the opportunity to go head to head against the Motor City Machine Guns, so this is a first for them. But I'm sure they'll be dominant as ever. Victor brushing off those first couple of shots that Alex Shelley got in, and he sends Shelley shoulder first into the ring post. And that could be his match right there. Victor, the Wasteland Warrior. He knows how to pick apart his opponent. And I'm sure he'll be targeting that shoulder now, as he's already laid the marker. But look how quick Alex Shelley was to his feet. And here we go, into a Russian leg sweep, taking Victor down. And Alex Shelley locking in that headlock there. What is this? Just getting extra leverage on that headlock. Almost trying to snap the neck of Victor. He's going to have to be careful there. Victor, if he wants to continue in this match and continue with his career. Alex Shelley with those quick fists to the side of the head. But Victor says no. We'll have less of that. Can't quite believe, though, that we're seeing the Motor City Machine Guns here on NXT. Victor with a huge scoop slam, as he does need to get out of that corner quickly. And he does, and he makes the tag to Connor, and in comes the big man. Alex Shelley saying, I don't want any of Connor, as he brings in Chris Sabin, who goes straight at Connor, looking for a clothesline, but Connor just made that hip toss look so easy, and oh, what a slap to the back of the neck of Sabin. And Sabin back to his feet, countering that other blow which was incoming. And oh man, Connor, such strength, that spine buster to Chris Sabin, who is still down and out in this match. And there's another tag, bringing in Connor. Connor fancies summer. Chris Sabin, Sabin with that quick drop kick to the knee. And what a quick move there from Sabin, taking Victor down, goes for the cover, has that leg hooked, so close to the ropes though, but Victor doesn't need them as he kicks out at just one. And we've got some double team move here, double Russian leg sweep from Alex Shelley and Chris Sabin. Sabin going for the cover, Connor knocked from the ring apron, he's down onto the mats. This could be it after that double Russian leg sweep, and it's just a two count for Chris Sabin. And Alex Shelley of the Motor City Machine Guns, kick to the midsection, a swift punch to the head of Victor, but Victor back in control. And it's all kicking off outside the ring here between Alex Shelley and Connor, as Sabin and Victor continue on inside the ring here. Chris Sabin going to that middle rope now. What does he have in mind? He's waiting for Victor to get back to his feet, who's totally unaware of Sabin. Oh! Fantastic spinning European uppercut to Victor. Goes for the cover. Has that leg hooked? Two! And Victor kicks out at two. Mason showing from the Motor City Machine Guns here on their debut this evening. Victor back to his feet now. Sabin sending him into the ropes. Goes down. Victor over the top, underneath. And Chris Sabin, flapjack! Victor eating canvas. Wow, the Ascension, they're not in a good place at the moment. They're supposed to be the NXT Tag Team Champions. Maybe the ring rust is playing a massive part here this evening. Alex Shelley tagged himself in. This is the Motor City Machine Guns at their finest. What a kick from Chris Sabin going over to Connor. He misses the move, but gets a two count there. And there is just so much action going on, it's hard to keep up. Connor tried to come into the ring to break up the count. Didn't have to, as Victor kicked out at two. And then Sabin hit him with that bulldog, sending him to the outside. Now Shelley went for that kick off the top rope. And now Shelley's still back on his feet. What is this? Goes for the roll-up pin. Could he get it here now? Two, three. Oh, my word. The Motor City Machine Guns have defeated the NXT Tag Team Champions, the Ascension. Not the prettiest of matches from the Ascension. They just didn't seem to be themselves here this evening, as the Motor City Machine Guns were certainly in a lot better form. This victory though, this victory will certainly go a long way. Hell, we could be seeing these two teams face off once again soon, as it could earn them a shot at the NXT Championships with this win. You can see Chris Sabin earlier on in the match went to that second rope and executed that spinning European uppercut. Nicely done. Connor could see that his teammate was in a world of trouble, tried to get back into the ring, but Victor did kick out too, and this was it for Victor. He just couldn't break out of the cover. Sabin watched on. Shelley got the three count for the Motor City Machine Guns. What an amazing win. What a huge win as we kick off this new era on NXT. The Ascension nowhere to be seen. They've took their NXT championships. Embarrassing stuff from the Ascension. Oh! What is this? What is going on? Who are these two attacking the Motor City Machine Guns? They've just jumped the barricade. Alex Shelley and Chris Sabin, they've just got done celebrating their victory over the Ascension. And now, surely it's not Jay and Mark Briscoe, the Briscoe brothers here in NXT? This can't be happening. It's absolutely laying waste here to Sabin and Shelley. Shelley somehow managed to fight back here against Jay Briscoe in the ring. And look at Mark Briscoe to Chris Sabin. It's just so much going on at the moment. Russian leg sweep to Alex Shelley. The steel ring steps even coming into play as well. Oh man, it's just a mauling, a beatdown to the Motor City Machine Guns by the Briscoe brothers. I certainly wasn't expecting to see this. What are they doing here? Briscoe brothers on NXT. Well, that's certainly one way of introducing yourself to the NXT roster by defeating the team that's just defeated the NXT Tag Team Champions, Mark and Jay Briscoe, the Briscoe Brothers, here in NXT. As announced earlier in his interview with Renee Young, Kevin Owens is set to go head-to-head against Samoa Joe in tonight's main event. If Kevin Owens wins, he gets another crack at Sami Zayn's championship. Well, speaking of Sami Zayn, the NXT champion, who has held on to that title now for so long, is making his way to the ring here this evening. And I don't think he's about to address the fact that he's managed to retain his title against his former friend Kevin Owens, but I think he's here to address what happens at the end of that TLC match at NXT Rebellion. As Zayn was making his way back down the ladder after recapturing the NXT Championship, who should be jumping the fan barricade? Only Kevin Nash. Kevin Nash made his way into the ring, attacked Zayn from behind, hit him with two jackknife power bombs, and I'm sure Sami Zayn wants to address that here this evening, wants to try and clear things up and get to the bottom of why Nash attacked. Let's find out. Well, it's quite obvious that Sami Zayn is unhappy at the fact that he was attacked by Kevin Nash, someone that hasn't been seen in the WWE fit. Oh, no. No, Kevin Nash is here again. He's just jumped the fan barricade and Sami Zayn is totally unaware. You might want to turn around, Zayn. Oh, lights out for Sami Zayn. That's the last thing he saw, the last thing he expected to see the big man, Kevin Nash. Why are you doing this, Nash? Why are you here in NXT? Zayn somehow getting back to his feet. He's not in a good place though at the moment. He looks dazed over as he is about to be on the receiving end of yet another jackknife powerbomb from Kevin Nash. So, hold on a second, let me get this straight. Kevin Nash isn't even doing this for himself. He's doing this for a good friend of his. He's just come here to Full Sail University to scout out the opposition, to scout out the NXT champion Sami Zayn, and all for a paycheck. Typical Kevin Nash. It's time, ladies and gentlemen, for this evening's main event. Kevin Owens set to go head to head against Samoa Joe. Well, it's quite obvious that Kevin Owens took his frustration to Mr. McMahon that he wants a rematch for Sami Zayn's NXT Championship. He feels as though he deserves that after going through such hell at NXT Rebellion. But as we know, Mr. McMahon has put him in this main event here this evening against the one, the only Samoa Joe. If Owens wins, he gets another crack at Sami Zayn's NXT Championship. If he loses, then he's going to have to simply get back in line. And with this new era upon us, with these new superstars heading to NXT, opportunities like this for the likes of Kevin Owens are going to be more difficult to grab hold of. So Owens is going to have to go all out this evening against such tough opposition in Samoa Joe for this evening's main event. Well, everyone looks ready. I'm certainly ready for this. Kevin Owens, I'm not quite sure how he's doing at the moment, how he's feeling in himself after that hellacious TLC match at Rebellion. But I know one thing's for sure, Samoa Joe will pick that out. He'll recognize if Kevin Owens is hurting still from that main event as this match plays out. Samoa Joe debuted the week previous to NXT TakeOver Rebellion in that gauntlet match against Sami Zayn. He even pinned the NXT champion Sami Zayn. He's on a bit of a roll at the moment. Picked up some momentum with that win against Sami Zayn. I'm sure it's given him such confidence as well heading into this match tonight against Kevin Owens. Owens watching Samoa Joe from the outside of the ring there, keeping a close eye on him. One thing's for sure, we're in for a hell of a match between these two tonight. Both different styles. Samoa Joe preferring to go for that submission tap out style, whereas Kevin Owens is more of a ground and pound and Joe's certainly going to watch out for that pop-up powerbomb, which can be so devastating. It's certainly going to take a lot for both superstars to get the upper hand in this match. Both guys have so much experience in this business. 15 plus years, it's a long time in that squared circle. And we are off for this evening's main event. Kevin Owens against Samoa Joe. And it's Kevin Owens using all of his strength to get Joe into that corner there. The referee going to have to break this hold up. And Kevin Owens, he's angry at the moment. He's feeling it after losing out on that NXT Championship. He did come so close numerous times in that main event against Sami Zayn at NXT TakeOver Rebellion. And he certainly seemed confident in that pre-match interview with Renee Young of getting the win here against Samoa Joe. He's just executed that backdrop to Kevin Owens, just slamming his wrist onto the canvas. So unforgiving. And Samoa Joe bringing Owens back to his feet, sending him into the ropes. And oh, what a forearm smash, taking Owens down. Certainly not the start Kevin Owens wanted to this match. And now Samoa Joe has that arm bar locked in. He's just wrenching it back. And is Owens going to tap? No, he's not. He's going to work his way out of it. As these two are at a standoff. Nice arm drag there by Kevin Owens. And a kick to the midsection. What is this? A package pile driver to Samoa Joe so early on in this match. What is Owens doing here? He's just lining Samoa Joe up for something. Just bringing him up to the table position. Dropping that double axe handle onto the spine of Joe. And now Kevin Owens somehow lifting up the weight of Joe. Bringing him back down with that nice suplex. And just look at choking Samoa Joe. He's just choking him. And the referee not able to do anything. Unless he exceeds the five count. And he's just locking in that neck of Joe. Kevin Owens, incredible. You can just tell, you know, he's just taking his frustration out on Samoa Joe at losing the NXT Championship and potentially losing an opportunity for a rematch if he wasn't to beat Joe here tonight. Owens gets himself off the back of Joe, and now Owens with a twisting. Oh, just drops Joe's head and spine onto his knee. And that could very well be it. As the referee at two, and Joe somehow kicks out at two there. Unbelievable. I mean, it's such a devastating maneuver to drop the back of that head onto the knee. Could cause so many problems. Could even cost Joe this match in the long run. As Owens sends him into the corner. Such power behind that. And look at these fists to the midsection, to the head of Joe. Placing him precariously on the top, but look at Joe though. He's on the top rope. Leg lariat to Kevin Owens. It's one of the main qualities of Samoa Joe. He is unpredictable. He may be a bigger chap, but you just don't know what he's got up his sleeve for the opposition, as we've just seen from the top rope with that leg lariat. Now, oh, Kevin Owens with that inverted sit down suplex onto the back of the head of Joe. Goes for the cover at two, and Joe just about kicks out again. Kevin Owens really taking full control of this match. And now Kevin Owens with a go-home driver to Samoa Joe. Two. Oh, Joe kicks out at two again. How is he taking this punishment from Kevin Owens? He's just going full steam at Samoa Joe. He really wants another opportunity at Sami Zayn's NXT Championship. How he managed to get the strength together to pick up Samoa Joe and twist him round four. That go-home driver sent on there from Owens as he continues to pile on the punishment to Joe. Going for the roll-up here. He's got his shoulders on the mat for the count. Two. And Joe kicks out again. Joe kicks out at two again. Go back to his feet. And what a slap to Owens. Just knocking the snot right out of him. And now Samoa Joe with that suicide dive to the outside on Owens. He is willing and able to put everything at risk, Samoa Joe. He knows that if he was to get the win over Kevin Owens here this evening, it'll certainly put his name on the map for a chance at Sami Zayn's NXT Championship. And it's as simple as that. Joe sending Owens back into the ring. He could easily have left him out there. But no, he takes him back into the ring. Wants to end this as clean as possible, Joe. what he's all about. He's got that arm locked in at the moment. Kevin Owens isn't going anywhere. Showing no sign of getting out of this. And look at Joe, how he just keeps cinching back that arm. In the end, breaking up the hold. A nice DDT to follow up there on Kevin Owens. So now with Joe Knight in the driver's seat against Owens. What's he got planned here? Oh, wow. Just lifting the weight, the dead weight, I should say, of Kevin Owens. And just tossing him across the ring. Now Joe, Irish whip to the corner to Owens. Sends him back into the corner. Joe with a German suplex to Kevin Owens. And it's Samoa Joe that's picking up some momentum now in this main event. Kevin Owens back to a vertical base, and there's Samoa Joe bringing him back down to his knees. Educated feet. That kick across the chest as Samoa Joe taunts him a little, shares a few words with Kevin Owens. And they certainly wouldn't have been nice. And now Samoa Joe with a kick to the sternum of Kevin Owens, who's really suffering now. Kevin, you can see it on his face as he's wincing at the pain that has been inflicted on him by Samoa Joe. Oh, wow, what a chop. What a chop across the chest of Owens, and that could very well be it. It would be amazing if he could get the three count here, Joe, but Kevin Owens kicks out at two after being on the receiving end of such a horrifying chop across the chest. Joe just propping Owens up into the corner here. Oh, it's a gurry to the back of the head of Kevin Owens. He is out. Owens is out of this match. I think the effects of that TLC match Owens had against Sami Zayn back at Rebellion is coming into play here, as he's just unable to fight back against Samoa Joe. And now Joe, oh, we know what's coming up next. Joe has Owens on his shoulders. Muscle buster to Kevin Owens. Let's see that one more time. Oh, what a devastating move. Samoa Joe back to his feet, feeling it as well, goes for the cover, has that leg hooked. This could be it. Three, and Samoa Joe has defeated Kevin Owens here this evening. What is Kevin Owens going to do now? There goes his opportunity for a rematch at the NXT Championship. I'm sure we're going to find out soon, as that's all we've got time for on this week's edition of NXT. Thanks for watching, everyone.